chote utataka nitakupa ma.
Hey guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. It's your girl Fanny Lungu, back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course do not forget to subscribe. Today I'm going to be reacting to the Beast of the Earth Final Sign. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
Now we get to the issue of the Dabba, and the Dabba is mentioned in the Quran. The Dabba, the beast, is mentioned in the Quran. Surah Naml, verse 82. وَإِذَا وَقَعَ الْقَوْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَخْرَجْنَا لَهُمْ دَابَّةً مِنَ الْأَرْضِ تُكَلِّمُهُمْ أَنَّ النَّاسَ كَانُوا بِآيَتِنَا لَا يُوقِنُونَ. This is in the Quran, Dabba. Once the command has been given, which means once judgment is khalas, that's it, too late now. Once the motion has been set in, that's it, end is coming, the end is near. فَإِذَا وَقَعَ الْقَوْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Is that فَإِذَا or إِذَا حَتَّى وَإِذَا وَإِذَا وَقَعَ الْقَوْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ أَخْرَجْنَا لَهُمْ دَابَّةً مِنَ الْأَرْضِ. We shall bring out for them دَابَّةً مِنَ الْأَرْضِ, a beast from this earth. تُكَلِّمُهُمْ, the beast will speak to them. And it will say أَنَّ النَّاسَ كَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا لَا يُوقِنُونَ. People would not believe in our signs. It's too late now. We told you to believe, you didn't. You did not believe. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, hadith is a Sahih Muslim, three are the things when they appear, there is no fa'ida in a person accepting iman if they hadn't accepted it before this. Number one, the rising of the sun from the west. Number two, the Dajjal. And number three, the beast of the earth. And this is a hadith that has caused a little bit of commentary controversy, because Dajjal, can you not accept after the Dajjal comes? That's a bit of a controversy. And some ulama have said, maybe this is, you know, so anyway, that's it. But the point is, these two are explicitly mentioned. The rising of the sun from the west and the Dabbatul Ard, the beast of the earth. When these two happen, then there is no repentance. And if a person has not accepted iman, end of story. Now, what is this Dabba and what are the details? Jayyid. The Quran has only this one verse. The hadith, there is a lot of apocryphal hadith that are found in the very obscure works that are not mainstream. As for the famous six books of hadith, the only authentic hadith mention Dabba, and that's it. No adjective, no description. It just mentions the beast of the earth. There is a hadith in Tirmidhi that Tirmidhi himself says is weak. It is a weak hadith without any ikhtilaf. You look it up, the isnad is obvious. There's a person in there. Clearly it is weak. But it is in Tirmidhi. And it is not an authentic hadith. But the hadith says that the Dabba shall have with it the Asa Musa, the staff of Moses, and the Khatim Sulaiman, and the ring of Sulaiman. Right? So it says that this Dabba in one hand will carry the staff, and the other hand a ring. However, this seems to be coming from Judeo-Christian sources, where the beast will have the staff and the ring. This is, and the hadith is weak, or very weak to be more precise. And even though it's in Tirmidhi, but Tirmidhi himself says that this hadith is not authentic. In Musnad Imam Ahmad, there is a hadith that has an unknown chain. Once again, it's weak, it is not authentic, in which it says that the Dabba will mark people with a symbol. The Dabba will stamp, and stamp people with iman and kufr, who's a Muslim, who's a kafir. And this hadith, firstly, is not authentic. Secondly, it is problematic in terms of its content. It says the Dabba will stamp people with mu'min and kafir. But when is the Dabba coming? There are no mu'mins left in earth. So even from a content-wise, it doesn't make any sense. The isnad is weak anyway. It's Muslim Imam Ahmad with a weak chain. So even from a content point of view, by the time the Dabba comes, the Quran, where is it? The Kalima, where is it? Allah, Allah is not being mentioned on earth. We already talked about that, right? That generation will come where there is no actual Quran left. So the Dabba will come at a time when it's the last day. Literally, it's the last day on existence. The Dabba will come out, and that is too late, obviously, at that point in time for anybody to accept. Now, Allah knows best, but in my humble opinion, we don't have any information about the Dabba, so we leave it at is it. It is a Dabba. What does it look like? You know, what it has? The Quran does not mention, the hadith is not authentic. It is one of the signs of the last day, and that's all that we know. Now, all of us living in this land have heard of the beast. We know the beast. Unfortunately, not through the Quran and the whatnot. We know it from Christian folklore, because it is something that is common in Christian folklore. The beast is, of course, believed in by many strands of Christianity, and that is because the book of Revelations mentions the beast. In fact, the book of Revelations mentions two beasts, the beast of the water and the beast of the earth. And this is interesting because the title is the beast of the land. And in the Quran, Dabbata min al-ard. It's very similar. The beast from the land, Dabbata min al-ard. And if you, for the advanced students, those are interested, Revelation 16:2. And Revelations 19:20, if you want to look it up, 16:2 and 19:20, it marks the issue of the beast. And the book of Revelations also mentions that the enigmatic number is 666 that will come with the beast. We have no such thing as 666. That's only found in Judeo-Christian literature. And I'm just narrating it to you, FYI sake. We do not believe in this, in numerology anyway. We do not believe in the whole issue of numbers. And we also don't believe in 786, by the way, as well, guys. Sorry to burst your bubble, but no, 786 doesn't carry any weight. You either write Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, or you don't write anything. No need to write 786 at the top. That doesn't bring the barakah. It does not bring the barakah that you want to bring, and so it should. There's no point in doing that. I'm not saying it's haram, kufr, shirk. I'm simply saying it means nothing. You might as well write 123 or 276, whatever you want to do. It doesn't mean anything. There's no point in doing that. Either you write it or you don't write it. Anyway, that was a tangent. Let's get that. What were we saying? The dabba. So the dabba has no explicit information. We let it as it is. The Quran mentions it. The Sunnah mentions it. There's no description about it. What does appear to be the case, the sun rising and the dabba seem to occur within 24 hours. And it is essentially the last of the 10 signs before the trumpet will be blown. Is that clear? That's what it looks like to me. The very last day. It looks like from the ahadith that when the sun rises from the west, the dabba will come out in 2-3 hours, because that's after Fajr Salah, the duha time, and the trumpet will be blown on that same day, later on someday. That's what it looks like. It doesn't say so, but that's what seems to be the case, and Allah Azza wa Jal knows best.
The end of the world is actually scary if you think about it, because no one really knows what's going to happen. So that being said, I mean, there's the talk of the beast coming, but then if it's mentioned in different religions, then there should really be some sort of beast that's going to come during end times. But then I'm confused. So the beast and Dajjal are two different things. If I remember correctly, Dajjal is all about spreading false information, and people are going to believe like, okay, maybe this is the Messiah that has come, but it won't be that. But then there's also mention of the beast. So is it the Dajjal first, that's when the beast, that's when the trumpet is blown, or what? No. Then after that, the entire earth will be consumed or reset. Help me understand that if you understand it better. But otherwise, whatever the case is, let's not just believe everything that's put out there. Like he was saying, he was quoting from weak hadiths or sources. No, sources. He was quoting from weak sources, but then he's just putting the information out there that this has been mentioned in different religions. And I guess it's just a warning that be aware of things out there or whatever is happening out there. Why don't Muslims believe in 666? Can someone explain that to me? I'm really, really interested. And what's the other number he said? Was it 7 something? Where is that from? What does it mean? Otherwise, this was interesting. Let me know what you guys think. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.